Hey everyone, this is Remi. Today I'm going to walk you through step-by-step how to build your own scraper for Product Hunt. We're going to be using FireCrawl in order to scrape everything, and then we're going to be using Apollo to enrich all of that data. So let me dive right in. Create your n8n workflow from scratch. And what we're going to be doing is, if you go to Product Hunt, select a category. I selected a random one for hiring software here. As you can see here, it is actually showing a lot of the information. And as you can see, it is showing companies that were recently launched. So we're going to be scraping all of that, as well as the page and the view details that will show all of the information. So in order to do that, you're going to have to create a FireCrawl account. FireCrawl is something that turns websites into LLM-ready data, so that's perfect for AI. There is a specific API that they have, so you can just generate an API key and then you're ready to go. And we'll be hitting that endpoint in a second. So let's get started. So first we're going to trigger manually. And then right after that, we're going to use the HTTP request in order to make a call to FireCrawl. As you can see from here, this is a post information to the scrape endpoint. So I'm going to be grabbing that URL as a post. Here's the URL. And the authentication, you can have generic, and they're using bare auth. I already have mine in here, but you can create a new one and just paste in your API key and you're all set to go. Then you're going to be sending your body. We'll be sending as JSON. And here's the JSON that we're going to be using. So let me walk you through it right now. So first, the URL, right? So I'm using legal services, and this is the URL that I was just showing you, and it's ordering by recent launches, which is, let's say that's what you want for your niche. And then secondly, we're going to be using JSON as the return format so that the workflow can understand that better. And then we only want the main content. We're going to be excluding some extra data that is not needed. And what is really good about this here is the prompt. You have the ability to pass in the prompt directly that will give you the ability to filter everything out. So in here, I'm able to say, I only want to extract the URLs from the specific page that contain /products, which are all the links to view details. And it will return the output in the specific format that I defined here. And then even better is, as you can see on the original page, it only shows the top 10, but if you want to actually get more, you have to press the button, see more product. Now, I was able to go and inspect that button. You can go in there, you can right click, and in the copy, you can get the selector here. The selector is exactly what I'm pasting in here. As you can see, you can do specific actions. So I'm waiting for 1 second, then I'm clicking that specific selector, then I'm waiting again. And so that will give me the ability to have 20 leads. I could copy paste the click wait a few more times and I could easily get to 100, 200 leads. And then that's it. This is everything that you need to pass in. This is all in the public API documentation. So you can just go through that. There's more options on what you can do with the software, but of course everything is documented in here. We can even test it live, and that's going to actually run through that test immediately. There we go. So it was able to grab all of that information, and there we go. It picked up the 20 URLs from there. Again, I could have a lot more in here. This is perfect. For this example, it's perfect. I have 20 here. Then because it returns one item, we actually want to turn that into 20 items. So we're going to do a split. And you're going to be trying to find the list of URLs from here. So this is the URLs. You can drag that in here. And then destination field name will be URL, just for clean data, so that each will be named URL. There we go. We have a table with all the URLs. This is perfect. It turned my one item into 20. So now it's going to be able to loop through that and actually scrape the rest. All right, we're going to be doing another HTTP request, which will actually scrape each of the sub pages. This is still the post. This is very similar to what we had before. This is going to be the same endpoint. This is the same authentication. We're still going to send JSON body. It's a very similar format. It's just that we don't want to take any action on this one. So very similar, except that the prompt is now, your mission is to only extract the company name, website, and maker name, because each profile has a maker name or a list of names, which you could also get here if you wanted to. Actually, for testing purposes, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to limit the 20 into 1. So I only get could start from the last one. It doesn't really matter. You can do first or last. So that allows me to only test one specific company for now. So while I'm testing, I'm not constantly rerunning 20 API calls, kind of maxing out my free trial already. So this is what I have. So now if I run it, it's going to be faster because I only have one. We get to remove the limit later on when it's ready to actually go live. And let's see what it found. Let's go into schema, JSON, company name, website, and maker name. That seems to be correct. So now we're going to be building on top of that. Now we're going to be enriching that information by putting that into Apollo, which will return a LinkedIn URL, an email, possibly both. So we're doing another HTTP node, but the difference is that we're going to be using Apollo's API key. So you can just go to developer.apollo.io, and then you can generate an API key from there. I've used this one in a previous video about lead scoring, so I'm just going to reuse that one. And let's go right in. So we're going to be posting the URL from the URL from the documentation. I'm just going to paste that in. I'm going to link all of those documentation URLs into the description here, so you can see those API docs for yourself. We're going to be using generic, and it's going to be a header auth. So very similar, you will need to create your own. For Apollo, it's using X API key as the name. That's very important. If not, it's not going to work and you're going to have authentication issues. And then you put in your API key inside the value here. I've already done that, so I'm going to X out. But for you, you should definitely do that. And then we're going to be sending a query parameter. In the documentation, they're saying you should pass in the name and the organization name. And we're going to be using, of course, what we just received into company name and maker's name. All right, we're going to be running that. Let's see what it returns. That was pretty quick. It actually found the LinkedIn URL. Nice. Even has a photo, has the headline. Employment history. Yeah, you got the full LinkedIn pretty much. So Apollo's scraping from LinkedIn roughly. So yeah, you have all the information in here. I don't think we have the email, but sometimes you'll get the email. Sometimes you get the LinkedIn. You get the organization LinkedIn as well. So that's also nice to have. That was also in the original product hunt. So I guess you could also get both. And very last step is, well, we want to be storing all of that into a Google Sheet so that you can easily filter later on and eventually upload that into your CRM if you wanted to. So I'm going to add a Google Sheet. So I'm adding a Google Sheet here, and I'm going to be appending rows. All right, I got the product hunt leads spreadsheet that I have. Right, so this spreadsheet is really just an empty sheet with just the headers that I'm going to pass in. It's important to have the headers because then it's required for the mapping here. So it's asking for the company. So we're going to be grabbing everything from the lead. Actually, it'll be easier from the top. I'll be getting from the first HTTP call, we're getting the JSON. If you remember, we are getting the company name, we're getting the website, and we're getting the maker name. It's usually the founder. They just call it a maker on the site. And then from Apollo, which is the HTTP request too, probably could have named that a bit better. You can rename the node easily for clarity. And we're going to be finding all the information from the person. So we have the LinkedIn URL. I'm going to be dragging in here. And let me see, do we have the email? No, email is empty for this one, but there we go. Let's run the test. Let's see. And it added all of that. So there we go. We have the information for that lead. And as soon as we delete the limit here, we're going to be able to rerun the entire thing. So let's just do that. It says a little warning because things are different. The previous node changed. So let's run the entire workflow again. And there we go. We just scraped the 20 leads. It just took a few minutes to run through everything, but you have all those leads to work from and all the websites, and there are other ways to enrich and score those different leads. I have another video on this that I'll link here, but of course use all of this. And that was just 20. Of course, as you've seen before, you can add a lot more of those and add more clicks in order to load more data in. I mean, you could load easily 100, 200 leads and go from there. So you could try some other enrichment platforms as well that might give better data, or You might want to directly scrape from LinkedIn. There are many ways to do that. You could also use Appify to connect to Product Hunt, but there's a monthly fee plus a per result type of fee. So that's what I wanted to show you today. This is all completely free because FireCrawl has a free tier, Apollo has a free tier, and Product Hunt on the web is completely free. So yeah, if that provided value, please like and subscribe. It really helps promote my content. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next one.